Good morning, folks. Meteorologist Chris Jarzynka in for Haley LaPointe. And boy, Haley has got to know how to pick her time off months in advance. She always gets the best weather. And man, oh man, this next several days, going to be fantastic. Now, it is going to be a little cool this weekend. And certainly after the warm and humid stuff that we had late last week, it is going to be quite a change, a refreshing change for some. Now, we do have a little bit of a cool pocket of air, and because the sun is so strong this time of year and there's a bit of a disturbance mixing things up in southern Canada, we are going to have the potential of just a few widely scattered sprinkles in and north of the White Mountains today, and maybe even overnight tonight during the early evening hours. However, the atmosphere is really starved for moisture, so a lot of what you're even seeing on radar here showing up as green across Quebec and also in through the Green Mountain State, it's going to tend to dry up before it even reaches the ground. So it'll be cool and noticeably less humid. And when it's less humid, it's cool during the day to mild, but it gets quite cool at night, and we're going to drop down into the 40s in most places during the overnight hours tonight and even into Monday morning. And I wouldn't be surprised with a few of the notches and hollows up north, we drop into the upper 30s. Yeah, it's still technically spring, but it is June. Now, the thing is there's really no storms across the entire country, or at least no organized storminess, except just south of Chicago, moving through Indiana and through the Ohio River Valley. That is eventually going to become a cutoff area of low pressure, which is really not going to be connected to the jet stream at all, which is going to ride to the north of us. And as a result, along this green strip, that's pretty much where the clouds and the storms, really the battleground, is going to stay for the next several days. We stay cool to mild, although things do start to warm up each and every day next week, but it really won't be all that humid, whereas the really hot stuff stays off to the south, and certainly the humid stuff too, because even though it warms up next week, it's not going to be all that humid. So for the day today, it's going to be a little bit breezy along the coastline, but really not too much of a breeze. High temperatures ranging from, get this, the upper 50s to near 60 north, to the 60s to lower 70 south. And by the way, if you are doing some socially distant time out on the beach or perhaps out on the ocean, you are going to be dealing with a light north-northeasterly wind, eventually slowly shifting around to the south later today. It's a light breeze. The sea's running about 2 to 3 feet. Your ocean temperature is actually warmer than the lake temperature. I don't know when I've ever said that, but the Lake Winnipesaukee temperature, because of this dry air and the very cool spring we had, is too cold to swim safely. UV index, around a 7 because of some extra clouds starting to pop up during the afternoon. We passed a high tide just before 6 o'clock this morning, so the next one will be coming at 6:37 this evening. For socially distancing, you will have plenty of sand to distance on, let's say around noontime, as your low tide comes up at 12:31 this afternoon. For overnight tonight, there you go. Upper 30s in Whitefield, around 40 in Berlin. The temperatures elsewhere, warmer, but I mean, only in the mid to upper 40s, which for the middle part of June is rather chilly, 51 along the coast. And for the day tomorrow, it is looking nice. We'll call it mostly cloudy, partly sunny up north, with increasing amounts of sunshine the farther south you go. High temperatures, though, only in the mid 60s north to low 70 south, cooler at the coast with a sea breeze. The average high this time of year, as you see there, is 77, so we'll be a little bit off the mark, but for those of us that like the lower humidity and the slightly cooler feel, especially for outdoor activity, it's got to be really, really nice. By the way, if you are planning on heading up to the mountains and hiking the mountains, it is going to be quite chilly the higher you go. It's only going to be in the 30s on top of Mount Washington both weekend days. So really prepare yourself for 40s and 50s if you're climbing any mountains, let's say, with elevations above 3,000 feet. It does start to warm up as we move into early next week. We're back into the mid-70s away from the coast on Monday, cooler at the coast Tuesday and Wednesday, but we're back into the 80s by Tuesday and Wednesday, but it's not all that humid. Highs in the upper 80s to near 90, with finally the chance of a widely scattered rumble of thunder coming in by the end of the upcoming week. Thanks very much for clicking on this WMUR weather on the web videocast.